Why you're gonna fail trading just technicals? Guys, the markets are entering a new cycle. I am seeing a number of red flags on a macro level indicating we're gonna be entering into an economic downturn. After we've had this period of boom, we're gonna have this bust. That's the way the markets move. We go have booms and we have busts. That's part of economic cycles, macros 101. You would have seen not long ago, right, where we had a mini flash crash. And, you know, just to try and put it into a nutshell, effectively, you would have seen Japanese markets, right? Asian markets had a mini flash crash, a crash to the downside, which was recovered over a couple of sessions. But regardless, these are the sort of things that are going to be happening on a regular basis when we get these economic downturns, these unpredictable moves, unless you understand on a macro level what's going on. So with that, what we had was the Bank of Japan, okay, the Japanese central bank. They started raising interest rates because for many, many years, Japan had low rates, okay? They had negative rates, right? And the reason for that was because they're trying to bring up their inflationary levels, right? Just to give you a bit more insight into that. When we are introducing low rates and negative rates, we're trying to encourage spending because effectively when we're lowering interest rates, we're lowering people's costs, we're lowering their borrowing costs, you know, outstanding mortgages, or if they want to take out a mortgage, cost to borrow is less. So it encourages people to want to go and borrow money and go and spend and stimulate the economy. And obviously when we're spending and stimulating the economy, prices rise, okay? Price of goods and services rise. So Japan also had a negative rate. Now what that means is if they have a negative rate, it costs people to keep money in their bank accounts. So if it costs people to just have money in their bank accounts, what do you think these people are going to go and do? They're going to take that money out of their bank and they're going to go and spend. They're going to go and buy these stocks. They're going to go invest in stocks. They're going to go and buy these goods and services. They're going to start spending to stimulate prices, to stimulate the economy. And that's what the Bank of Japan wanted to do. So for many, many years, Japan had low rates. So that turns off a foreign investor. No one wants to invest where, you know, there's no yield being earned. In other major economies, the United States, the United Kingdom, New Zealand, Australia, Canada, Eurozone, UK, you name it, all of these major economies were offering higher rates, higher yields for a foreign investor. So where do you think the foreign investment was going? It was going in all these high yielding economies. Do you understand? People were selling yen to go invest into major economies that are offering a yield. So listen to this. In Japan, you could go and borrow money, right? Remember, the interest is down, it's like nothing. You can go and borrow money for nothing. Imagine that. You go and get a loan out for 100K. This is just speaking in theory. You go and get a loan out for 150K, whatever. And then you go and take that money where you're not paying any interest really and go and invest it into the United States. Go invest it into UK stocks, Eurozone stocks, Australian stocks, whatever. So in order to do that, we had to sell yen, right? Stay with me here. This is very important. We had to sell yen and then we're going to go and invest in the United States. So we need dollars. We need GP. We need Aussie. We need NZD. So we get weakness in yen and we get strength in those other currencies, right? So what was happening there, guys, when you look at the chart, dollar yen, Aussie yen, CAD yen, GP yen, all of the yen pairs were moving in one direction because Japan was offering low rates and all these other economies were offering higher rates. So in order to obviously invest in those economies, we need those respective currencies. So effectively, GP was strengthening, dollar was strengthening, euro was strengthening, Aussie, all of those currencies were strengthening versus the yen. So it's just one directional movements. Now, this is the important thing. This is why I want you to stay with me here. This is all part of what we're talking about. So then the Bank of Japan, after finally bringing up inflation, right? They brought up inflationary levels. People, you know, they brought up inflation. So they started to change monetary policy. So they introduced rate hikes, okay? They introduced rate hikes. Now, you know, before where we had low rates in Japan, there was a divergence because other major central banks were hiking rates, right? We had other economies hiking, the BOJ was lowering. So there was a divergence. Now we're entering a new cycle because we're getting this potential bust. We're getting an economic slowdown. All major economy central banks, we've seen it, ECB, Bank of England, FOMC are getting close. Now, by the time you watch the video, they may have cut rates. Bank of Canada, you know, all these other major central banks are starting to cut rates or, you know, still talking about rate cuts, the future of rate cuts to come. But the Bank of Japan are now raising rates. So you see how we had that divergence before? That divergence is no more, you know, essentially, right? That divergence is diminishing because now instead we're getting the Bank of Japan raise rates. Other economies are cutting rates. So this is now a potential positive, you know, for the yen on that divergence. Do you understand? So what we had initially where people were selling yen and buying other currencies, we had, that's known as the carry trade, right? You borrow in low yielding, you go and invest in higher yielding economies. That's the carry trade. So when the Bank of Japan started hiking rates and they made it clear, look, we're on a rate hiking path now. We're going to start hiking rates. We had a massive unwinding of that carry trade scenario. So where all those yen pairs were moving in one direction, we had a massive unwinding of that. Guys, I'm pleased to announce I'm going to be entering a partnership with Carbon Capital. Now, I haven't entertained any of these sort of partnerships for an extremely long time because I just know how many sharks are in this industry. And still to this day, for myself on a broker level, I only trade with two brokers that I can personally vouch for and trust. And that's where I split my risk over these 15 years, okay? Now I'm going to be opening up my doors to Carbon Capital. I've started trading with them because I know these guys on a personal level, okay? These two brokers I've been trading for years is because they've been well established, but now I have that personal relationship with Carbon Capital, so I'm opening up my books to them and of course entertaining and making this partnership happen. Now, one of the key things as well is we have a lot of synergy and we are aligned on providing value, right, to traders like yourselves. And for me, why I exist today is because I saw a massive disconnect in, you know, information that professional traders at institutions were getting, or just professional traders with big books, and they were getting all this macro knowledge, they were understanding how to actually trade that. But the retail trader, the information that these professional traders were getting was just jargon to the everyday person. So that used to frustrate me. So I wanted to get this information and break it down and make it simplified for traders like yourselves to be able to action and profit off as well. You know, it's not just for the greedy professional traders. No, it's for the retail traders, small guy as well, to make a profit. And a lot of that content, obviously, that you've seen from me over the years, we're going to be turning it up a notch because we're about to enter a new critical market cycle, okay, which we're going to go into detail with a lot of this content, which Carbon Capital are, which I'm proud to say, are going to be sponsoring, just so that you guys can get the full the full energy from me, the full value. They're going to be sponsoring a lot of this content, so make sure you stay tuned in this community. And of course, as I say, I wouldn't be here, sat here opening up the doors to Carbon Capital if I didn't have full faith and trust in them providing what's in the best interest of you as a trader. Effectively, people started closing those positions. The big players started closing those positions. And obviously with the market, right? Market is built up of a lot of sheep, a herd of sheep. And that's where sheep get slaughtered, right? And if you are not part of this level of macro knowledge that I have, which I simplify, you can get it. You will be slaughtered like a sheep in this current economic cycle. I warn you, you will. You'll be getting hit with blows left, right, and center. You'll get slashed. You know, beaten to a bloody pulp. And I know I'm putting a lot of emphasis on that, but it's important that you stay with me because that will happen to you and you're not going to understand. I still get messages every single day, people saying, oh, Ken, why this happened? I just blew up my account, or I just lost my funded challenge, or I lost my funded account. And it's like, this is what happened. And they're like, oh, wow, thank you. So anyway, back to the point. We had a massive unwinding. We've been having an unwinding of that carry trade scenario because the Bank of Japan has started hiking rates. So obviously we're now getting people close out that carry trade scenario, big institutions. And as I said about the herd following, so we're getting more trades being closed. And you know where people had been so short Japanese yen, you know, with their brokers, with their institution trading, now obviously they'd be getting margin calls, right? Because their position where they've been long all these yen pairs is now going the wrong way because we're getting closing out of that carry trade. And obviously now people getting margin calls. Now in order to get out of that position, they have to buy back yen. So we saw this massive flow into JPY, and that's why the markets just crashed. You know, we had all this flow going back into yen. You know, all the yen pairs spiked aggressively to the downside. So flow into yen, weakness in other currencies, the Nikkei crashed, you know. And just to bring it all back to you guys, you see what I just explained here? This is the new cycle that we're going to be entering. The market is going to be prone to potential black swan events. The market's going to be prone to flash crashes. I spoke about this years ago where we had flash crashes. And, you know, you say,
you can't be prepared for flash crashes.
Yes, you can. You can at least be well and truly informed about what's going on, because I was aware of that Japanese situation because we were in tune. You know, we had our finger on the pulse with these fundamentals. I'd have been speaking about it for a very long time. Okay, so just to bring this back in again, We're entering this new economic cycle, guys. It's so extremely important. Be ready for all these sporadic moves, which you would think are sporadic, which you'd think are unpredictable. But no, on a macro level, you will be aware and you'll understand why you can be better positioned for it. And not even just be better positioned, at least be able to capitalize on it as well. And don't get slaughtered by just thinking on a narrow-minded level that technicals come first and the fundamentals follow the technicals. Do not be so stupid and naive to that. Anyway, guys, stay tuned for more value and more content.